Hello, in this video, we're going to add a variant to an existing product in our Shopify store. So let's go ahead and jump right into our Shopify admin screen. Along the left-hand side, go ahead and select products. And here is the demo product that we have set up in the store. So we're going to select that as well. So adding variants to the product here on the product detail page, if you scroll all the way down to the bottom, the second to the last block is labeled variants. And at first look, it doesn't seem like it's capable of adding all the additional colors and sizes that you want until you select this block. So go ahead and check that and you'll see it opens up the section for some different options. Before we add any options and we get into the variants themselves, I'm going to recommend that you come up into the media section and add the photos of the different variants within your store. So in this case, I have a demo white t-shirt here. I'm going to add two other t-shirts that are in different colors. So I have three different colors available, and then I'm going to add some sizes in the variant section. So let me go ahead and add these additional colored t-shirts. And there they are. So I now have a white t-shirt, a blue, and a sand colored t-shirt ready to go. And you're gonna see later on why it really helps to have the images loaded before you get too deep into adding and editing the variants. So let's go back down to the variants section here. Option one gives us defaults to size, but if you click in there, you'll see all the different options that you can do by default within the Shopify platform. So let's stick with that default of size and let's add small, comma, medium, comma, large, comma, and extra large. So I now have all of these different sizes available for the t-shirts. But now I also have some colors that I want to add. So let's click add another option. Color defaults as the second choice, which is perfect for us. So let's add white, sand, and blue. And there we have that. So now those are the different variants that we have. If we go below that, you'll see this screen here in the preview has a bunch of options for us, but I'm going to show you an easier way to go ahead and make these changes to all the variants. In order to do that, we first have to go up and click save. A good rule of thumb too is when you're adding, every time you add a lot of information, go ahead and click save anyway, just so you don't lose that information. But particularly for variants, you'll notice once I've clicked save, the variant section moves up. Whereas before, we had only that small little section there. We didn't have the photos available there. It was only a couple of options. So once we click save, the variants section changes for us. So let's go left to right within the variant section here, and let's look at changing these different variables within the variant itself. So we want to add an image. Instead of going through and adding an image for each variant as we go through the list, we're going to do it a little bit easier way. You'll see up here it says select. So let's go ahead and select white. If we select white, it automatically checks the box for all the products that are the color white. We can now select the drop-down arrow here under More Actions and add an image. When we go to add image, it pulls all the images that we had preloaded, which goes back to why I recommend adding the images right off the bat. So we can select the white t-shirt, click done, and boom, all the white t-shirts have the white t-shirt image attached to it. So let's do that for the sand. Add image, we'll select the sand shirt, done. Those get added. We'll select the blue, add images, we select the blue t-shirt, and boom. And there we go, all the variants now have the different colored images attached with them. And this is gonna be important because later when we're looking at the front end and we select the different colors, it will change the image that the customer or potential customer is looking at. So let's go ahead and click save on that. And just so you know, within this, once you have this loaded, you can go through and make all kinds of changes in a more bulk type of way by selecting them here. So if I wanted to make a change to all the small t-shirts, if I click small like that, I can come in here and maybe if I have a better image for the small, I could put that in there. Maybe I don't sell as many smalls and I want to edit the quantity on that. So let's do that. So let's go ahead and edit quantity. So I want to apply this quantity to all variants. So maybe for the shirts that I ordered, I only ordered 5 of each of the smalls. So I can put 5 in there, apply to all, and then click save. So now I have a specific quantity for the small shirts. So let's do that for all of them. I'm gonna go into medium. I'm gonna adjust the quantities here. Let's say I ordered 10 mediums. We'll apply to all, and we'll save that. The larges, same thing. Let's say we did 10 as well. Apply to all, we'll save that. And then for the extra larges, let's say we don't sell as many of those. So we'll take that, not images. We'll take that back down to 5, apply to all, and save. So now we've been able to go in and edit those quantities a lot quicker than going in individually for each one. Okay, now before we go ahead and look and see what the customer is going to see, let's look at this edit button real quick, and you'll see each one has one. So let's start with this small white shirt here. We'll click edit. When we click on that, it pulls up a detailed screen for that particular variant. So maybe the small shirts, right, have something specific with them. Maybe their weight is less, or this particular small white shirt, the actual cost per item, maybe because there's not as much ink being used on the t-shirt, is actually a little less. Whatever it is, if you need to make specific edits to that particular variant of the product, that's how you would go ahead and do that. So let's go ahead and hit the back button here. And let's see what the customer is now going to see that we've added variants. So up top here, we go to more actions. Let's click on preview. And we can see now that the layout of the product has changed a bit. There are now these variants that are available for the customer to pick from when they're ordering. So if I want to order a medium, I would select and move through. Now what's nice is because we've attached the images with the specific color, if I click on sand, then the main image changes. Most of the time you have these images down below and people will know what the different colors is. However, there's been many times when I'm not too sure what that color name specifically is, especially if you have something like maybe pink or rose, what's the difference, or dark blue and navy blue. So it's always good to you know, sync them so that when someone does click on blue, they know exactly what that blue colored t-shirt is going to look like. Okay, now we come back here into the Shopify admin screen. That is how you add variants into the product. But one last thing I want to show you in here is this more options drop down button. So when we were looking at the preview screen earlier, let's go back to that real quick. We see we have white, sand, and blue lined up, but maybe we want to change this order of the variants for whatever reason. Maybe we're trying to push a particular product or we just want that order changed. So if we click more options, we could reorder the variants here. So you'll see right now it has the white, sand, and blue. So I can move that over here and do blue, white, and sand. Maybe I want to make blue the first option for whatever reason. So if I click save on that, and I go back into preview, you'll see the blue is the first option that shows up and the corresponding image that shows with it. So just some customization that you can do with the variants. But that's it. That's how you add variants to the product in the Shopify admin. I hope that helps you. I'll see you in the next video.